What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel.
Most, if not all, of the programming languages you might use during an interview are object-oriented. And to see if you are familiar with data structures in OOP, the interviewer might ask you to actually design and implement a data structure from scratch. It could be a linked list, a stack, a queue, a map, etc. We previously explained and implemented several data structures in our data structure series. So today we will be re-implementing one of them again with a little twist. In this video, we will be implementing the queue data structure while making use of the built-in stack classes and functionalities in Java. As a quick reminder, a stack follows what we call a LIFO structure, where the last item pushed to the stack is the first item that is popped from the stack. However, queues follow what we call a FIFO structure, where the first item in queued is the first item to be dequeued from the queue, just like any waiting line at a cinema or a vending machine or a parking machine. With that said, how are we going to take the properties of a stack, apply them, manipulate them in a particular way in order to build a queue? The first thing that comes to mind is that the queue has two distinct pointers, the head reserved for dequeuing elements from the top of the queue, and the tail reserved for enqueuing elements to the back of the queue. On the other hand, the stack has only one pointer, the top or root pointer, used for both the push and pop operations. After this observation, some of you may think that if, for a queue, we need two of them, and we have only one, then we might as well use two stacks to replicate the queue behavior. And to these people I say, you are right. Let's see what using two stacks will look like. Suppose you have the following two stacks and this queue partially filled with the same elements. Up until this point, if we want to dequeue an item from the first queue represented by the two stacks, or dequeue the same item from the second queue, we will have a similar behavior. However, if we are pushing or enqueuing an item into the queue, the behavior will change. As in the first one, the element will be pushed on top of 6, however in the second it will be enqueued after 4. To fix this and replicate the second queue behavior into the first one, what we can do is pop all the elements from the first stack onto the second one, add our item there, and then pop all these elements again from the second stack back to our first one. By doing this, we replicated the same exact behavior of the queue using two stacks. Now to implement our queue class, we will first start by creating two stacks. Our target is basically to implement the isEmpty, the peak, the enqueue, and the dequeue functionalities. Okay, as we saw, the content of our queue is ultimately reflected in the first stack. So to check if the queue is empty, all we have to do is check if the first stack is empty. Similarly, to peek at the next element to dequeue, all we have to do is return the top element of the first stack. Now, we also mentioned that dequeuing an element from the queue has the same exact behavior as popping an element from the top of our first stack. So, to implement this, all we have to do is check if our first stack is not empty, we return the popped element at its top. Finally, to enqueue an element in the queue represented by the two stacks, the first step we need to do is empty the first stack into the second one by making use of the push and pop methods. Then, we have to insert the element to enqueue at the top of our second stack, and at last, we empty back the second stack into our first one with the help of the pop and push methods as well. To test our development, I made use of the built-in Java queue functionalities by enqueuing and dequeuing a few elements from the queue created. We can now compare these results to the ones we obtained by using the queue we just implemented. As you can see, the results are similar, and our queue behaves exactly as a normal queue would. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.